Your mother says no.
What?
Don't start with me.
I don't even want to carve stupid pumpkin. I hate you.
Yeah, well, get in line. Okay.
Really?
Yeah, okay.
Yes! Dad! Mom said yes!
All right! Come here! Ah. Hey, listen, you got your first football practice tomorrow, huh?
Yeah.
You want me to take you?
No, Mom's taking me.
Yeah, but won't you be embarrassed? She's a girl.
Nah, she's cool.
All right, go ahead. I'll see you Friday.
Love
you. Love you, too. Hey, Teej.
Yeah?
Say goodbye to Mom.
Bye, Mom.
Nice. Nice touch.
Where'd you get that?
Mom, or Debbie gave it to me.
Cool. Hope you thanked her.
I did.
Guys. Elizabeth, is that you?
Yes, Daddy.
Come in here.
Have what it takes to make it.
Hi. I put the keys on the table downstairs. Thank you.
We missed you at church. Again. What is that? 4 Sundays in a row?
3.
I guess I'm coming next week. You've been letting the important things in life slip a little, Elizabeth. A lot, in fact, since you moved on campus.
School's not important.
Of course it is,
but you can go to school just as easily living at home. Now, we've hardly seen you this month. And that Roger fellow called a number of times, said he can't get in touch with you.
I've just been busy getting acclimated, in homework and stuff. I'm sure that once I get a handle on things, I will be able to juggle it better.
Family is not something that you juggle, Elizabeth, nor is church. Now, you know how important it is to your mother that we all be there.
Yes, sir.
Good. Then it's settled. I'll call the school first thing tomorrow morning and make the necessary arrangements.
Necessary arrangements for what?
For you to move back home. Get your priorities back on track.
Daddy, no. No, if you want me to be at church every weekend, I will be there, but I just need to reorganize things a bit. But please let me stay. You know I can handle it, right? So just tell him.
Right.
You'll make it to church with us every Sunday?
Yes.
Your mother and I will not put up with this much longer.
Yes. I will be there every weekend, no matter what.
Not because we say so, Elizabeth, but because it's right.
Yes, because it is right.
See, I told you it wouldn't be a problem.
We will be following that story.
When does the steam start to work?
I sure hope it's soon, child. I sure hope it's soon.
Okay, let's get right into it.
This is always my favorite part, finding out who went where. Sauna. Nude beach. Adult bookstore.
Thanks for bringing him. Did I miss anything?
Yeah, the coach took like about a half an hour to suit them up and show them how to put on their uniforms. It's like, they're not the Marines. Who cares?
I don't want to talk about it.
I didn't say anything. I just hate to see you so upset. There you go!
I don't like to see you so upset every time you come from talking to him or his house. He's a piece of shit.
I can handle him. I can handle his shit. I'm fine.
Okay, fine. Handle it.
Look at that coach, I mean. How'd you like to be underneath him when he does that over and over and over again?
He's a kid.
That's exactly the point. Do you have any idea how many hours he could probably go for? How many different positions he could get you into? He's probably so virile and just bursting at the seams.
I'm sure Paul would love to hear you lesson after the coach.
Paul who?
The bottom line is, I'm used to...
Okay, calm down, Alex.
I gotta remember, they're not used to...
Where's
you know, for work, you know, because I've been working with kids now, like this, you know what I'm saying? So, I keep forgetting that a lot of these kids don't have the experience that Brian has, you know what I'm saying? But I've been teaching him since he
was... I need to go spend some time with the other parents, too, so I'm just going to step over there.
Yeah, no problem. I'll see you tomorrow, Coach.
All right, see.
Every time I get him, it's like clockwork.
So there's no punches from the famous Miss Katowski, huh?
Well, not unless you call me Mrs. Gutowski again. It's Miss Percy. Why am I famous?
Well, you're the only parent that knew how to suit up their kid. It's impressive. Now, TJ and I had to show the rest of them how to suit up right. It's quite an art form.
Yeah, I have a lot of older brothers.
So, are you going to be at every practice?
Okay, well, I have a husband to go home to, unlike some of my friends that are single. Alone.
Okay.
Thank you. I'm gonna go too.
Am I gonna see you tomorrow?
Tomorrow?
Practice?
At practice, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, I'll see you tomorrow practice.
Okay.
Bye, Coach Lang.
Call me Roy.
No, I'll be seeing you, Coach Lang.
Sorry, pick it up, pick it up. Keep moving. Hustle back, there you go. I like it. Good job.
Shut up.
Come on, ladies.
Oh, no.
Miss Taylor?
I could have sworn I saw her in the window when we were walking up.
No. Now, how could you have seen anything with that eyesight of yours?
Miss Taylor, it's Reverend Patterson.
Need me to tell you what your lotto numbers are?
Look, she's not home.
I'm telling you both, she was there.
Well, maybe she's indisposed. We'll give her a moment longer.
Toward the poor.
My eyesight is just as fine as it was when I was a teenager.
The poor woman is simply not at home.
Oh, Lord.
I mean, it's just too cold of a day for us to be standing out here like this. Why don't we just slip the card in the mailbox and then head on home?
Tell me my eyes are gone, please.
Yoo-hoo!
Well, I'm sorry I haven't got much to offer you, but I wasn't expecting coming in.
No, this is fine, just fine. Right, ladies?
We sure missed your muffins at today's bake sale.
And last night at Dingo. Mm-hmm.
Well, I've just been so...
Not to mention the past few weeks' services. Now, I'm not suggesting that your behavior is any way, well, unchristian. Mm-hmm. Heaven knows that there are few souls here on earth whose relationship with Jesus is as pure as yours.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Hallelujah.
But the church provides a person with much more than just peace with the Lord. Mm-hmm. It provides us all, myself included, a community which much of our lives revolve.
Oh, glory.
And many of us in that community are concerned with. That is to say, perhaps your isolation as of late is not the wisest of action for both body and soul.
Amen. Well, I am touched by your concern. I truly am. But I assure you that both body and soul are doing just fine. I'm fine. Well.
Well, that's that then. Sister Taylor, your soul may indeed be fine, but I can tell you, the rest of the congregation is missing something by your absence. Now, your singing is truly missed.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Well, hey, why don't we hear that voice right now?
Yes.
Yes.
No, sir. Please.
Oh. No!
Stop!
Oh. I'm tired, that's all. Thank you all for coming by. It was nice to see you all.
Sister, Jesus gives us all our crosses to bear. And we must carry that burden, for it is what he wants. Now, I know losing Marvin was tough, but
I'll do my best to come to next week's service.
Well, will you sing for us then?
I'll do my best.
All right.
Yes, thank you. Thank you for coming back. I'm just tired as all. No need to make assumptions as to my behavior. I just don't feel like singing anymore. Looks like it's just the two of us today.
Yeah.
It seems like our partner don't need the steam no more. But us, huh? I guess we needed something awful.
Something awful.
Well, me, I can feel it. The nastiness, the dirt. Just dripping off me.
You can?
No, child. But it sure don't hurt to pretend.
So you really wouldn't mind taking some of the kids to the game?
No, of course not. I can fit a couple. I actually can fit a bunch, because I have a pretty big car.
You're a lifesaver.
It's a minivan. It's got like 7 or 8 seats. I don't know if you've ever seen one, but they're pretty huge.
Not the help stuff.
Great for kids.
Yeah, we'll know.
All right. Well, I appreciate it. I really do. And I guess I'll see you tomorrow?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll see you. Usually work out at that time tomorrow. This is actually the time she goes to the gym. Pumps iron.
Stop it. Goodbye.
All right. Bye.
Actually, Roy, are you going that way? Because Lori's actually going the exact same direction. Did you want to hop in her car and maybe just do a little carpool?
No, it's okay. Actually, I have somebody coming to pick me up in just a second, so it's okay. Thank you anyway, though.
Okay, well, zip her up, cutie.
I'll see you tomorrow, Lori.
Okay.
All right.
Bye.
Bye.
See ya. What are you doing?
What?
What are you doing? I mean, what? He is foaming at the mouth like a Tibetan mastiff, and you are sitting here playing, what, hard to get?
I'm not playing hard to get. I'm impossible to get, because I just have no intention of getting gotten.
Really?
Yeah, really.
That's interesting. So who are you dressing up for today?
You.
Right. I don't think so. I think you need to go over there before he gets picked up by his mommy and ask him on a date.
No, it's ridiculous. He's at least 15 years younger than me. I can't.
Exactly. That's why you should go do it. Men hit on younger women all the time. Tommy did it to you.
Well, all the more reason.
That's actually a very good point, but I still think that you should go over there. He likes you. He likes you.
You're right. I'm not too old for him.
No, you are not.
And I want to, and he's very, very, very cute.
Go. I'll be right here waiting for you.
All
right. Be strong and be sexy. Yeah. Open your jacket.
Hey. Sweetie.
Hey, how you been?
Hi.
You look good. What's going on?
Oh, look at you. You ready to go,
Hannah? Let's go.
Lori.
That was stupid. I'm stupid. It's all stupid, and I don't ever want to talk about it. TJ, honey, you have homework. Let's go.
Lori, please don't.
No.
Come on, Alex.
Thank you.
Hello? Hold on. Hey, Beth, this is for you.
Who is it?
I don't know.
This is Beth.
Hi, it's Nyla.
From Gender Roles and Society.
Oh! Hi.
Hello.
I was wondering if you had any plans on Saturday.
No.
Cool, because I wanted to see if you'd come to Navratri with me.
It's a club.
You'll see.
That's great.
Was that a yes?
That's correct.
Okay, I'm psyched. How about we meet in front of the student center at 7?
Yeah.
Are you sure you're okay?
Absolutely.
Oh, is there someone that you can't talk in front of?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I see. So, Saturday at 7.
That's fine.
Oh, and Elizabeth.
Yeah?
You looked really cute in that red sweater the other day.
The tight one.
Oh. Damn. Ah, can't make brownies without the walnuts. If I send my baby girl brownies without the walnuts, she'll have me put away for sure. Well, keep talking to yourself, girl, and you'll be put away. Walnuts or not.
Looking for chocolate chips?
No.
Frosting?
Mm-hmm.
I know, lemon filling for your award-winning pie?
No, I'm looking for diamond walnuts.
Walnuts?
Mm-hmm. Yes, walnuts. You know, they've moved everything around in here. You can never find the same thing again.
Here's the walnuts, but why on God's good earth do you need them?
For my brownies.
Wait a second. You can't put walnuts in brownies. That's the biggest mistake people make, always putting walnuts in brownies. See, I you struck me as somewhat of a connoisseur of food and stuff in the kitchen, but I guess I was wrong. Anyone knows anything about anything, don't put walnuts in brownies.
She won't
be needing these things. Here.
Excuse me, Mr.
August.
I don't recall asking for your advice.
Well, that's true, ma'am. You didn't, but I won't hold that against you. Maybe I was a little hasty. I do remember some who still use walnuts, but believe me, ma'am, my way's the best.
Oh, fine. Believe that. No skin off my nose.
Good, as long as you concede.
I what?
Admit I'm right. I don't blame you. It's obvious. Good night.
I haven't conceded to anything. I just wanted you to stop harassing me about the blasted walnuts.
If that's what you want to tell yourself, who am I to break your denial?
Huh? Denial? Mm-hmm. You crazy old man. My walnut brownies would be 10 times better than anything you could bake.
I don't think so.
I know so.
Yeah, well, I'll tell you, there's only one way to decide. We'll have dinner. After which, we'll try the brownies. One of yours, three of mine.
That's the most foolish thing I ever heard.
I knew you'd be afraid to risk it.
I don't even know your name, and you expect me to...
August Winslow. And I'm pleased to meet you.
Doris Taylor.
All right, now, Doris, how about 7 on Saturday? I don't live far from here.
We'll eat at my house. Oh, home court advantage.
Good job. Hustle. Come on back. Cuts. Come on back. There you go. That's as far as you need to go. Ready?
Get in there.
Come back? Yeah.
Yeah, and then you come back midfield. There you go. Good hustle.
Thank you.
They still have mass on Saturday afternoons, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's good.
I was thinking about going to that one.
You mean in addition to Sunday?
As opposed to? Daddy?
What's wrong with Sunday?
Nothing's wrong with Sunday. It's just so early, and I'm gonna go out with some friends the night before, so I thought I could go to Saturday Mass instead.
No.
But Daddy, why does it matter when I go? I'm still going, right? You wanted me to get my priorities in order, so I'm making church a priority. I'm making church such a priority that I'm gonna plan ahead and think I might be tired on Sunday, so.
Why would you be tired?
Because I wanna go out the night before, and church is early.
See, what did I tell you?
Are you ashamed of us? What?
You heard your mother. Are you ashamed?
No, I'm not ashamed. I just thought it would make more sense.
Well, it doesn't. The point is to spend more time with your family. Now, you are treading on very thin ice, young lady, so I'd watch it. You'll be there Sunday morning, and that's that. Understand?
Yes, sir.
Ride, Roy.
No problem, man. Hey.
Hey.
We missed you today.
Yeah, actually, Jackie was supposed to bring him home.
No, yeah, she was. But I was kind of heading this way already, so she...
So she suggested you drive him.
Oh, well, yeah.
Yeah, I have to talk to her about that, you know, firmly. Thank you, and I'm making time.
Hey, listen. I was just thinking maybe, maybe if you're not doing anything... Might possibly, you know, really just kind of whatever you want to.
You've got to be kidding me.
I do?
I'm not that desperate. I may not look that fabulous right now.
Yes, you do.
But I'm not desperate just because I'm twice your age.
I don't care how old you are.
And what happened? Your girlfriend got busy this weekend?
My girlfriend?
Yeah. Little Miss Perfect with a fake breast who picked you up yesterday.
Oh. Mindy.
Mindy. Good night.
No. Mindy's my sister.
What?
She's my sister. She was in town on business, so I had her come swing by. And she came to...
Oh.
Oh, and by the way, they're real.
Of course.
So, Saturday.
Saturday. Oh, no, I have TJ's... No, wait. No, TJ. TJ's actually going camping with his father this weekend.
Perfect. Okay, I'll pick you up at 7.
I didn't say yes.
Yeah, you did.
Nope. When?
Just a second ago. Okay, fine. Lori, will you go on a date with me this Saturday?
Yes.
Great. I'll pick you up at 7. Can't wait.
Okay.
Try. flowers for the beautiful hostess.
Spared no expense, huh?
Something smells good, good.
Must be the brownies.
Wow, no, don't you start straight out. I think we should declare a truce.
A truce?
Yes, there's no sense in the two of us fussing over something so silly. Cut down on the black-on-black crime. I'm sure your brownies are just as fine as mine.
But you can't bake, so...
Not for my life.
Please, come on.
Oh, thank you.
Hi, I'm so sorry I'm late. My roommate was being
Don't
such...
Don't worry, we have plenty of time. I am gonna go. You look great.
Thanks, so do you.
Mind if we stop in here for some smokes? You smoke?
No. Yes? I could.
Flexible. I like that.
So did you see the first two Hellkeepers?
No.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
I thought everyone had seen the first two. All right, let me fill you in. Can I get one of those? Thanks. All right, let me fill you in. So in the first two, there's this demon called Razor, right? He comes down and he possesses a sexy college chick who's a virgin, of course. Right, yeah. So there's also this good demon who's not really a demon at all, I guess, if you think about it, because he's good. So there's this little subplot kind of thing going on.
Okay, you know what? I'm gonna catch on.
Okay. So how old were you when you had TJ?
I'm not gonna answer that question.
I'm sorry. It's not right to ask a girl her age, is it? My bad. But you, of all people, should be the last person to worry about something like that. I mean, you look great. I could have sworn you were born pregnant.
I'm 42.
Oh. I love the movies. I think right now is my favorite time, like right before the lights are about to go down, you know? Possibilities are limitless. When I was growing up, my father used to say that his favorite part was the coming attractions. And he'd do this thing every time before the previews. Before every preview, he'd grab my knee like that and shake it, get me all excited.
Why'd you ask me out?
What's that?
Why did you ask me out? I'm trying to understand it. I am almost twice your age, and I have a kid. I wouldn't trade him for the world, but I have him. And you're adorable and smart and sweet as a fucking Norman Rockwell painting. You seem normal. So I'm sure there are plenty of girls your age that are, you know, beautiful, sexy girls that would die for you.
I don't know. I think you're a really cool person. And yeah, you're probably right. There might be some girls my age that would be interested in dating me, but I just have never met anybody like you. And you've got that smile.
I still can't believe our kids grew up together. How is William? I haven't seen him since he was about 12.
Oh, he made out fine for himself. Made me proud. Oh. He is senior partner in one of the biggest law firms in New York.
Oh, you don't say.
Yes, I do. First black partner in this 60 years.
Oh, my.
I just wish his mother could have seen it.
Oh.
Billy really took a passing heart. He ain't right about it yet, truth be told.
How long has it been since you lost your wife?
Going on 11 years.
Oh, my.
She just turned 60 the week before. She was as beautiful that day as the first day I met her.
You still miss her?
Every day.
Every day.
Well, not like when she first passed. No, that was constant heartache. But I think about her each and every day for sure. Simple things, a laugh, a pair of earrings she was fond of. But she's not gone. She's still right here. I wouldn't ever want to not miss her. Missing her keeps her with me.
Yes, yes.
Well, that's the end of that. Hell, I'm bringing us all down. Let me take these.
Oh, no, please put that down. No guest of mine is going to be washing dishes. I do the cleaning around here.
I can't let you do it all by yourself, Lee. You're leaving me out here alone.
Well, it only take me a minute. I got me one of them dishwashers.
Yeah.
My daughter bought me one for Mother's Day last year.
Uh-huh.
Now, my son's another matter. I don't know. Well, anyway, my daughter, she's always buying me stuff she thinks I need. I guess it makes her feel less guilty.
Guilty about what?
Huh? Oh, about not coming around more, you know. But since Marvin, I guess it makes her feel obligated.
Mm-hmm.
More obligated.
Foolish kid.
Yeah, foolish kids.
Kid, yeah.
I'm not so foolish not to accept the stuff.
Of course not. Hey, feel like tickling the ivory a little bit.
Oh,
you gotta
I gotta get a tune. I just gotta.
Sure, yeah. I my arthritis is acting up anyway.
Yes, well.
Would you happen to have one of those compact disc players?
I've got a old-fashioned hi-fi.
Hi-fi is fine.
Well, it's a little dusty, but it sure works okay.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So, were you surprised when I called you?
Yeah. I didn't think you even knew my name.
It's hard not to notice someone craning their neck to look over.
Oh my God, was I that obvious?
I'm observant. If I never called you, would you have called me?
Oh no. I would have wanted to, but we're different.
I really want to kiss you. Can I? What's the matter?
Nothing. What you said.
You don't want to kiss me?
I want to kiss you, but it's not here.
What's wrong with here?
I think this place has a certain je ne sais quoi. You don't like it? No, I like it. It's fun.
Something you need to know about me right off the bat.
I need PDAs. Public displays of affection. Love them. Let me kiss you. Let's go for a walk. Have you ever done this before? Yeah, I've kissed a lot of people.
Women. Have you ever been with a woman?
Not technically.
But you are a lesbian.
Well...
Bi?
I don't like to label people.
Neither do I, but I need people to know that I'm bi.
And it's a lot of confusion. Let me kiss you.
What about my apartment? Would I be able to kiss you there?
My light is not that
yeah,
I
Yeah, I heard you. Public. Can I kiss you at my place? Yeah. Let's go then.
I'm sorry.
Why?
I know you didn't like the movie.
No, it's not that I didn't like it.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, oh, right. I didn't like it.
I know you didn't like it. If you just want to fill you in on it.
Right.
Maybe.
Stop.
Stop what?
Staring.
Was I staring?
Yeah.
I'm sorry. I'm just so, stareable.
Do you have a book with, like, the 100 top lines to flatter women?
Do they sound like lines? I mean them. I've always had that problem. I don't know. I think I was born without the part of the brain that censors things. Whatever I think, I just say, you know, regardless of how it may seem. Like, if I were to mention how beautiful your eyes are, they sound like a line, but it's true. I mean everything I say, and I definitely don't play games, so.
Is that line number 81?
I think it's more like 36, maybe 35. So whatever happened to TJ's father?
Oh, he had a midlife crisis, met a teenager, bought a sports car, took off.
He's gone?
No, not really. Unfortunately, he settled in Wachung with his blushing new bride.
So we just got freaked out about getting old and left? Or?
Yeah. We didn't have the most ideal marriage, but, you know, something like that.
I just can't imagine anything worth leaving you for.
Well, you haven't seen Debbie.
I don't need to. I've seen you.
Madame, would you care to dance?
Oh, stop!
Is that a no?
In the dining room?
What better place?
Doing here? I thought you were going out.
We were, but we've been moving more kits than we expected, so I figured we'd stay home, bang out around 100 more while we watch the movie. Come on in, relax.
Okay. Thanks. These are my roommates. Two of them anyway, the two who were supposed to be out.
Nice to meet you. Susan.
Hey, Sue. I'm Elizabeth.
Susan.
Sorry, Susan. And that over there is Gina.
Hi, Gina.
Sure like the pure ones, Nyla.
Fuck you.
I don't suppose you want to help with this, Nyla. I mean, you are only a member of the project.
It's Saturday night. Some of us have lives.
And you have enough for all three of us.
Take your coat off. Fancy a beer?
Yeah, that would be great.
Sorry about this.
Well, it's their house too, right?
I know. That they were supposed to be out. We could go back to your dorm.
No. This is fine.
Cool. They're kind of noisy. How about we go up to my room? I'm in the attic. It's quieter. Better to talk.
Yeah, like I said, I'm flexible.
That's all I've been thinking about.
So, what were your roommates doing down there?
They were just fucking around. They're rude, but cool.
No, in the bags. What were they putting in the bags?
Oh, you mean the kits? They're for IV drug users. Susan is the founder of the High Project. We go out and exchange clean needles for used ones.
You can do that?
No. It's technically illegal. But we do it anyway. Cops know, but as long as no one complains, they're cool.
But what if someone does?
They won't. The community knows we're trying to help. You should go with us on an outreach. Maybe become a volunteer.
Yeah, no, that would be cool.
Sit down. Get comfortable. Wanna hear some music?
Yeah, that'd be great.
Brin's okay.
Brin's is great.
Try and relax a bit, okay? This CD okay?
It's great.
Mind if I, turn down the lights?
That's great.
You okay?
Yeah. Why?
You're agreeing with everything I say.
I'm sorry.
Don't apologize. Just relax. So, you're nervous. Don't know what to expect.
Nope.
Never kissed a woman before.
Well, not,
technically.
Nope, not technically.
Wanna? Do you want to kiss me?
I think so.
Only think so. Don't know for sure.
I bet
you do.
I bet you want to.
Oh my God. I'm late for church.
Blow it off. Stay in bed with me. God will understand.
Yes, God will understand. But my father will not.
Oh God. Okay.
Here we go. Okay, all right, just where's my skirt?
Where's the skirt?
Yeah. Thank you. I'm dead. I am so dead. Where is my shirt? I don't have time for this.
Is this it?
No, this is mine.
Here, just give it to me. I know, I seem like a crazy person. I know this, but my father, he will put me into a tiny room.
Go, I'll call you. Oh, Beth, wait.
No, I have got to go.
Yeah, but you can't go to church in that shirt.
Save me.
it's safe to say that Jesus was saying you, as my apostle, must go.
I'm sorry.
I told you I'd make it.
Well, look at yourself. The word what are you wearing?
Last night's clothes.
Last night? But why?
Slept at a friend's house. When we
do a boy's. You spent the night in some boy's frat room, didn't you?
See, Diane, I told you.
Daddy, that's ridiculous.
Look at me. Look at me. Swear to me you did not sleep at some guy's last night.
I swear to God, I did not sleep at some guy's last night.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, my Lord and my
Mom, it's Yolanda. Are you there? Pick up, okay? I guess you're not there. We're a little concerned, Ronald and I. We haven't heard from you in a while, even though we've called at least 5 times. Mom, you really should try and get out and have some fun. It's not healthy to stay in all day and brood.
Okay, you know what? Now you're gloating. You're gloating. You need to spill it, okay? This is not fair.
I would like some details, please.
This is not fair at all. I am your friend. I've been very supportive of your relationship. If it wasn't for me, he would never have dropped TJ off at your house. You've been seeing him every night for the last 2 weeks, and I hear nothing. I get no details. I'm ready for some details. Okay. Okay. Waiting.
I never knew sex could be like this.
Shut up.
I have to be dreaming. I have to be dreaming.
Really?
He looks at me with lust in his eyes. And he can't keep his hands off me. Touches me. And then he apologizes for it like I would mind.
Oh my God, that's so cute.
And he always takes care of me first.
Who does that?
Nobody.
They only do that in pornos. Oh, enough already. Good job! Go, team!
What does Tommy think?
What the fuck what Tommy thinks about it? Tommy doesn't know.
Well, what about TJ?
TJ's good with it. TJ's good. He loves Roy. He doesn't exactly know, but he thinks Roy's just over a lot, like you're over a lot. It's fine.
It's like a romance novel. This sounds like a romance novel. Like when a man and a woman and he loves her. It never happens like that. It's like a movie. It's like Jerry Maguire or something even worse. Like Wedding Planner.
My muse, you come to me to free me, inspire me, liberate me, wake me, shake me. My muse, I never want to lose you. My dark skin savior who has fixed my behavior by lying down with me, caressing me, teaching me, taking me to the heights of such ecstasy that my jailers have kept from me since birth. My worth My muse.
That was very vivid, Elizabeth. Thank you for sharing.
They're coming, they're going, they're taking over our city. They're coming, they're going, they're taking over our city.
Yeah, we're like a storm, we stroll and we start to roll a paper yellow like a toman. And everything we say, they can take it to your dome. But please don't say that we're sexist. Just let us sleep at your house and cook us breakfast. Cause we like that. The freaks is crying. Please stop by and help yourself to my house.
TJ. TJ, get over here. TJ, talk to me. Let me look at your eye. TJ. TJ, you're gonna tell me what the hell happened just now, or you're never gonna have any fun again. No more shows.
I'll tape them.
Okay, no more dinner. You're not gonna eat. TJ, you're acting like a brat.
Brian says Roy is your boyfriend. Is he?
We've gone on some dates, yeah.
God, Mom, I can't believe this. I hate you, I really do.
So you, what, tried to beat up your friend because—
I hate you!
You said that.
If you thought I sucked so much, you could have told me. You didn't have to make Roy play me.
What the hell are you talking about?
Brian told me the only reason I play is because of you and Roy.
That's ridiculous.
You are such a liar! I wish I lived with Dad and Debbie.
What?
I'm gonna call Dad and see if I can live with him. He really sucks here.
Oh, that's fine, TJ.
You want to go live with Dad? That's just fine. I'm going to help you pack. But God forbid Mom should have a life, right? God forbid I should be happy. It's just all about TJ. Spoiled little brat.
Can you two just relax for a minute?
No, we will not relax. Look at you. What have you done to your hair? You've got hardware in your face.
It's no different than an earring.
But it's in your nose.
Yes, that's why they call it a nose ring.
Don't get fresh.
Mom, the silent treatment? That's mature.
Oh, and poking holes in your body is?
One hole.
What are you thinking? If you give any consideration at all to your future, how are you going to get a job looking like a pincushion?
I'm 19. When I'm ready to get a job in 6 years, I will think about it then. Oh. Mom, come on.
No wonder you haven't been by in weeks. You said it was midterms. I can't eat. It's obvious your mother can't either.
Waiter.
Daddy.
I'm sorry. My daughter has upset us so much, I'm afraid I'm going to have to ask for the check.
I can't believe we're going. I have to go to the bathroom. I'll be right back. Frank?
Hey. Hey. What did Dad say?
He wasn't home. Debbie said he'd call me when he gets back.
Mind if I sit down?
It's a free country.
Still mad.
I guess.
I don't blame you. I don't. Kind of mad at me, too.
You are?
Yeah. You know how you have homework and you practice for a test? I never got any practice for being a good mom. I just don't get it right sometimes. But that doesn't mean I don't love you. I should have told you about Roy. I should have. But just because I like him doesn't mean I love you any less. Now, if Dad says it's okay, you can live there. But I really wish you'd stay.
I don't want to leave. Debbie's cooking stinks. So I was just mad.
I know. Yeah, if Brian thinks you can't play.
I don't care about that.
You don't?
No, they're all boogers.
So why do I have ice on your eye?
Mom, forget it.
No.
Brian said that his dad said you have the best.
Oh, God. That's just wonderful.
Mom!
Thank you for defending my honor. But you know how I feel about violence.
I know. It sucks.
Hey.
Sorry.
You kiss your mother with that mouth?
Yes.
So come here.
What do you mean you took it out? My dad almost had me committed. My mom wouldn't even look in my direction.
I can't believe you.
Don't be like this. Nyla, will you just stop a second?
I gave you that ring.
I know.
And all it took was mommy and daddy to get a little uptight.
It was more than a little
uptight. You have to grow up sooner or later. Last thing I give you.
No, that's not fair. I'm still wearing it. I still have it. It still symbolizes
your fear of your folks.
No. Why would I upset them when it could be avoided?
Why should you change for them?
You don't know them. You don't know how pissed they were gonna be.
My parents come from a country where lesbians are stoned to death. So don't give me any of this. My parents are from a different generation. Crap. Okay.
I'm sorry. I know I plan on telling them that I'm a lesbian, but I am not ready.
What did you say?
I'm sorry.
No. Did I hear you use the L word?
Yeah.
When did this happen?
I don't know.
I'm so proud of you.
Women! You are now looking
at one of us. Beth here no longer feels that labels are restricting.
You are now looking at an official dyke. Let me get my camera. Here, have a beer.
Yeah, thanks. Hey, Susan, I was thinking about joining the High Project.
Wow, when you get involved, you really don't fuck around.
You do know it's technically illegal.
Yeah, so how illegal is it?
You don't really have to worry about it. It's the handling of the kits that get people arrested. But you can do other things.
Are you joining the project?
Yes, she is.
Great! That means you can come to the party.
Hold still.
What party?
It'll be fun.
Only project volunteers invited.
Will you guys just hold still?
But now that you are part of it...
Oh, that's so great. When is it? Thanksgiving night?
No, really.
Nyla, look at the camera.
Yeah, I can't go then, baby. What do you mean you can't go? I have to spend the day with my parents.
I'm just gonna take it.
It's at night, Beth.
I know, but we did this whole thing. We have to go to church, and we go to my grandfather's grave. It's like the
Tell
whole
thing. Tell them that you have plans in the night. This is important to me.
Okay, I can't do that, baby. It's not gonna happen.
You're choosing them over me.
I'm sorry.
Say cheese.
Oh, no. Oh, never. I mean, never again am I sitting in the back. You kept that darn window open all the... Just look at my hair. Just look at
it. You know what? It looks like it does all the time.
Oh, dear Lord. What have you brought to my doorstep now?
What's wrong?
Where's my coat? I gotta get my coat.
You are an evil woman, Miss Ella. Just evil.
Ladies, ladies, will you two please call a truce?
Oh, but she didn't.
Now, I mean it. How do you think it looks, two Christian women at each other's throats over nonsense?
It's just a minister and that.
Honey, ain't nothing just about them. They get in this house, ain't no way I get them out.
Now, we are here to help Sister Doris. Not to debate on who should sit in the front. A debate, I might remind you, that's older than the pyramids.
Yes, I agree.
You agree.
One look at you, and my whole life is over broadcast on the evening news.
Baby, why don't we just hide out in the kitchen?
Believe me, I've tried that. It doesn't work. Oh, look who it is. What a pleasant surprise. How are you all?
Who are you talking to in there?
We're fine, thank you. How about you? How you doing?
She was talking to someone in there.
Where are you off to?
The store.
For what?
Perhaps we can all go inside.
Doris, who's inside there with you?
No, I'm not going shopping. I'm just going for a walk. I usually walk to the 7-Eleven and back and exercise.
Yeah, well, it looks like it's going to rain.
Then I better get a move on.
Doris, why are you avoiding my question?
What question?
I heard you talking to someone as we were walking up.
Oh, Ellen, your ears haven't been right since you boiler exploded.
Back in 1978. What can I have you know?
I think I better get a move on.
Perhaps you will give us a few minutes of your time.
Why?
Well, we thought you could use some support.
What I could use is some privacy, not some self-serving minister and his two hens.
Well,
yes. You all feel so sorry for poor old Doris. She must be slowly dying of heartache. No other reason to miss your service. Right, Reverend?
Well, I never.
I haven't been to church because I haven't felt like it. I know where Jesus fits into my life just fine. And I don't need you coming here making me feel guilty.
My girl.
I can do without that, thank you.
We just wanted to see if you'd be coming to the Thanksgiving festival.
No. I have plans.
Do it?
None of your damn business. Now, if you'll excuse me. What am I doing? I'm not going anywhere.
Daughter-in-law, an old fella could wish for.
Oh, no, stop it.
Well, that's true. Straight William, right up.
This is my friend Doris.
Oh, so nice to meet you.
Yeah. Same here.
Charging the coats.
Sure smells good around here.
Well, that has less to do with me and more to do with the real cook.
My mom.
Oh, I don't think so.
Oh, yeah.
Well, can I help? I sure know my way around the kitchen.
No. I don't like to have guests in my kitchen.
Guests? Oh, girl, please, let me at least mash a potato.
Billy, guess who finally arrived? And in a tie to boot.
Dad, now don't you look respectable?
You know I taught you everything you know about looking good.
Thanks to my father.
Oh, my boy.
I feel like I've known you for a long, long time. Doris.
It's funny, I haven't heard a word about you.
Well, I didn't want to bother you with all your cases and such. I mean, I didn't think you didn't need a
I guess name. I've been hogging a lot of your father's time.
Doris is a little Nathaniel's mom. From the old neighborhood.
Oh, from over on Remsen.
Yeah, but now she's...
So what have you been doing with my father here? Oh. Since y'all been so busy and all.
Well, we've been going to the movies a lot. doing plenty of puzzles. Mm. And we're going to some really fantastic restaurants.
And I assume he paid, of course.
Billy. Yes, he did. He's very traditional when it comes to things like that.
We've had some real good times.
I have more family that I haven't seen in a long time.
I'm sorry about that. He's been under a lot of stress lately.
Yeah, I'm sure he has.
Thank you.
All right, home.
Hey! Mom!
Hey! Ah, I miss you so much! Did you have a good time?
Yeah, he had the time of his life.
Great.
Hey, Killer, run inside. I need to talk to your mom for a second.
Okay, go ahead. Go ahead. All right, go on. Jackie and Alexis will be here in a little while. Maybe we'll go miniature golfing.
So who's Roy?
Why?
Why? Well, TJ says he's over a lot.
Jealous?
No, don't flatter yourself. I'm just concerned about my child and the environment that he's exposed to. His coach, Laurie, it's sick. I mean, what do you think this is doing to TJ?
They get along?
Well, I'm sure they do, Laurie. They're closer in age to each other than you are.
What'd you do now? Did you interrogate your own son?
You realize how pitiful this is? You shacking up with someone so much younger?
I have an idea.
This is totally different. You're his mother, for Christ's sake. You could try acting like it instead of some whore. You always put your needs ahead of his. Even when you were pregnant with him, you never wanted a child to interfere with your life.
That's not true.
The groceries?
The groceries? You made me carry groceries from the car.
You needed to learn to balance a baby in one arm and the bags of groceries in the other. You had to build up your upper body strength.
Fuck you!
Oh, God, once again, we're reduced to profanity. Perfect. All right, I have to go now, but the bottom line is we're not happy. You could try putting someone else's needs ahead of your own for a change. He turned custody over to us. He needs a stable environment. This is a bad situation for him. You're broke, you're single, and now you're sleeping with a kid. You're a bad influence.
Excuse me. I have to go make a quick phone call.
A call?
Mm-hmm.
Who could you possibly be calling now?
A friend.
A guy?
A woman. A friend of mine didn't have anywhere to go for Thanksgiving, so I thought I'd call and make sure she's okay.
Sorry to keep everyone.
Well, now that the head of the table is here, Grace.
Lord, you've seen fit to bring us all together again this year, and for that we're thankful. We're thankful for the food before us and for the prosperity, both material and spiritual, yes, you have showered us with. But more importantly, Lord, we're thankful to you for keeping my mother, Clara, safe in the glory of heaven until we are reunited with her. For no finer woman has laid her feet on your green grass. Not a day goes by that I don't, or all of us who knew her, don't miss her. Amen.
Amen.
So, I know you just brought one bottle of wine.
You say that every year. Every year it says the same thing.
I'd like to make an announcement, if I may.
Of course.
As you know, or perhaps you don't know,
but you know now, Doris and I have spent a great deal of time together to find that kind of companionship at this stage in one's life. So I stand here and I say to everyone that I love.
And ask sweet Doris.
Where are you off to? Don't you see someone with a glass in their hand? I always taught my son to listen when someone is speaking.
Yeah. Well, my father also said, never listen to a fool.
Oh. I'm a fool now, huh?
Look at you, senior citizen, making eyes at someone. Make an ass out of yourself, Dad.
No, you just listen.
You see, I've been sitting here all night trying to keep quiet while my father humiliates himself. And now you want me to be happy seeing you disgrace Mama?
This has nothing to do with your mother. This has to do with me, the one who's still alive.
This has got everything to do with Mama. You think she'd be happy seeing the man she loved get railroaded by some geriatric gold digger?
Boy, you
stop calling me boy. I'm almost 50.
You ain't old enough for me to knock your block.
Dad! Bill!
You know what? The hell with this. The hell with this. Look at her, Dad. She's getting old. And from what I hear, her son's in and out of jail. The Lord knows he can't take care of her. So here comes along, my son's a lawyer, looking all pie-eyed, ready to spend cash on her. It's a payday for her. So congratulations. Looks like your ship is coming. Big time.
Happy Thanksgiving. Hey, Lori? Lori? Are you okay?
Eddie knows how to get to me. He just plays with my head. I know he does it, but I'm just... What if he's right? Just don't want to feel this way anymore.
I'll take care of it.
Hey, what the hell? Get down! What? Hey! Get off me! What do you want?
I want you to know exactly how you make Lori feel.
Lori, what the?
I want you to stop fucking
playing! All right!
Did you see my wrist? Those cuffs left bruises on my wrist.
Have you gone insane? If you have, we're gonna get you some help. But if you're not, in fact, crazy, could you explain what the hell you were thinking?
I wasn't thinking anything.
You got that right.
What are you so upset about? I was the one that got arrested.
I don't know, Roy. Maybe it has something to do with having to come down here and bail you out for beating up my husband?
Ex-husband.
Don't get cute.
I didn't beat him up anyway. I just wanted to scare him a little bit, you know?
You broke his nose. This is a conversation I'd have with my son. You're not 14. You can't go around beating people up because you don't like them.
I didn't do it because I don't like him.
Okay.
Look, I don't mean to sound like a baby, but you should be flattered.
Really?
I did it for you. I did it because all he ever does is hurt you.
I didn't ask you to do that. I didn't want you to do that. I didn't want you to hurt Tom. I wanted you to be there for me, to hold me, to tell me I'm a good mother, that I'm not selfish. That's what I needed.
Okay, sorry. I thought you wanted to.
No, you didn't.
I just said I'm sorry.
You didn't think about what I needed at all. I can handle shit myself. I don't need some twisted testosterone wet dream to come to my rescue.
Where are you going?
Home.
What about your car?
Right. You walk.
What?
I came down here, I bailed you out. You should be glad I did that much. I'm going home alone.
I can't believe this. What?
Maybe once the car's out of view, the reality of it all will come crashing on down.
Lori, please, come on. Lori. Lori. Lori!
Where are you going?
To see Nyla.
Wait a second. Let's talk.
We can talk later.
Beth, I really don't think you should go up there.
Why? What's going on?
Beth, stop!
I told you you needed to talk with her.
I'm sorry. She promised to tell you.
How long has this been going on?
I don't know, a month maybe?
And you all knew.
You're better off. Nyla's not the most faithful of women. You'll find someone
who's... Don't condescend.
I didn't mean to.
Beth, let's talk.
You want to talk? A fucking month goes by and now you want to talk.
I'm sure you're upset, but you really can't blame me.
Yeah? Watch me. Fuck you.
What time? The outreach. What time are we going?
Oh, Beth, don't worry about coming.
I will be there because it's important.
3:00.
Thank you. I'll see you at 3:00.
Such a shit.
Thank you.
For what?
The steam. At first I thought you were just talking, but coming here has really helped me.
Me too.
Oh, Lord. You too? Oh, who knows? I haven't been here in a while.
Yeah, me neither.
Haven't had the time.
But we're all here now.
Maybe we all need a little more cleansing.
I know you don't like when I don't call first, but I figured just this once might be okay. Considering.
Considering what?
Well, let's sit down for a second.
Okay. Now, I know you still have some reservations about dating,
but I'm just coming to realize how amazing you really are.
Roy.
Please, please, please. Let me finish before I chicken out. Now, I've been doing a lot of thinking. I love you. I mean, I really love you. I know I've said it 100 times, but I mean, it's like Romeo and Juliet kind of love.
No.
Think about it. We could be a family. We could do family things together. We could go on vacation. We could make memories together. We could have kids.
I've been down that road. It's overrated.
Yeah, but with a jerk. I'm not a jerk.
I don't want to be married anymore. I love my life. I like my friends, my independence.
A relationship is supposed to advance. Where are we going? It's not like I'm gonna date other women. I want a wife.
I'm not a wife.
Are you just playing hard to get?
I'm not gettable. Boy, I love you, but I'm not gonna lie to you. It's not gonna happen.
Do you realize what you're letting go? I'm a good guy, Lori.
You're wonderful. You're gonna make some woman very, very, very happy.
So you're just gonna let me go? You're gonna let me go just like that?
Yeah, we're gonna let each other go just like that.
I want to tell you, Susan, that I'm currently seeking employment because I really have to get away from this subhuman boyfriend here.
It sounds like a good plan. Figure out where you're going to live?
No, I don't know exactly where I'm going to be laying my head at nights yet, but I really have to get a new place. It's not really good for my mental health.
Sounds like it.
I know how that is.
What was that?
Nothing.
I don't have everything he requires, so I found him fucking my cousin, which is scandalous.
Let's go.
Yeah, I know, right? How shitty is it that someone won't complain about how they feel instead of lying to you and fucking everybody else in the world? It's not fair.
Right. I'll see you later, Susan.
Okay.
Look, babe, what's your problem?
My problem? I don't have a problem.
All day, this passive-aggressive shit. If you have anything to say, just say it. But you're scaring all our clients.
I'm scaring our clients? Yeah, right, like you give a damn. You're just pissed because I might scare off someone you could sleep with.
I don't sleep around. I love Jason because he isn't afraid of his mommy and daddy.
I am trying.
Girls, you're both pretty.
Tell her!
Me.
All day, she has been doing this shit. Susan, I told you her coming here was a big mistake.
You want me to leave?
No, I want you both to cut the shit.
Jeez. Fuck this. I'll go.
Susan, if she's here, fucking count me out. Nyla!
Come on, Susan. I want to get going.
Yeah, what's
okay.
up?
Okay, I'm sorry.
No, I'm sorry. How many are you turning in?
Shit, I already gave you them.
How many was it?
Six, Susan. Six.
And fucking hang around.
No, 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 wait. Beth, hand me those kits.
Okay.
Hand me the kits.
Sorry.
Need one?
Hey. Police, you're under arrest.
Up against the van.
Move.
I just got to get a few things to tide us over till Monday.
Well, make it snappy. I don't want to miss Idol.
Oh, I don't. Always got to have your face shoved in front of the television.
Hey. Wait, I got you. Whoa, I see you, man. Hey. I said, I'm going to get you. Bang!
You okay? Okay, here's what's up. I talked to Ramon, the project's lawyer. He's on his way down. We'll be out of here in a few hours. We have a fund for bail money, don't worry. This is bullshit. No big deal.
What the fuck are you talking about? No big deal. If my father finds out about this, I'm gonna get sent to a convent.
This isn't so bad. All these women.
I'm serious. This is the worst thing I can imagine. I wish they had shot me.
I'll see what I can do to get your charges dropped. Wrong place, wrong time. No one will be the wiser.
You can do that?
I'll talk to Ramon. No one will ever know you were involved.
Okay.
Elizabeth Barker?
Yes?
Bail's been posted.
That was quick. Too quick. Oh, God.
Hello, darling.
Hi.
Gentleman I play golf with called me up a little bit ago. He's a cop. Imagine my surprise when he told me that he just typed up your arrest sheet. Your mother's a trifle upset, but who can blame her? Her little baby was just brought in for distributing needles to known drug addicts. What the hell has happened to you? Answer me.
Nothing.
Nothing?
Look at you. You are in jail for drugs. You look like hell, you've humiliated your mother and me, and all you can say is nothing.
I'm sorry, sir.
You have no idea. Can we take our daughter now? We have had enough. You will leave college this semester and re-enroll next fall. You will live at home with us where we can keep an eye on you. You have screwed up for the last time, young lady. We're through coddling you. Let's go. Now. Elizabeth!
Do I have to?
No. Excuse me?
You mean just because they paid my bail, I'm not required to leave?
No.
I think I'll do that.
What the hell is this? Are you saying that you'd rather stay in here with them than go home with us?
Yeah. That sounds about right. Mom.
Yes?
I'm a lesbian.
Oh. Oh.
Here comes your ex-husband and his teenage bride. Shit. Your hair looks amazing. You can hardly tell it's a hairpiece. And your wife looks great. Is she going through puberty? That.
Some papers I had my attorney draw up, giving me full custody of TJ.
What?
Just sign it and we'll be done.
I'm not signing it.
You'd rather a long legal process, huh? That's what you want. Because you know how much an attorney charges, and you've got enough of that. And the thing is, Laura, even if you could scratch together that much bank, the question is, why would you want it? So TJ can watch his parents fight it out in court. Because he'd see the real you then, Laura. Your inability to make a decent living. Dating his coach the whole nine yards. It'd take months, cost you thousands of dollars, and in the end, the result would be the same as if you signed this little piece of paper right here, right now. Would you save yourself a couple of dollars and do it for TJ? For once in your life, do something for him and not for yourself.
Where do I sign?
Lori.
Hey, right here.
No, you are not signing that.
Is that where I put the date?
Yep.
Is that where I put that you cheated on me for 2 years?
What?
Is this where I put that you harassed me, manipulated me, and lied to me?
How are you doing?
Well, I'm signing the papers, Tom. That's what you want, isn't it? You want me to face the truth? That you're a selfish parent, that TJ's afraid of you,
That you force him to call Debbie mom even though he doesn't want to?
I never forced him to call her mom.
Oh, yes, you do.
Shut up.
No, I'm done shutting up.
Yeah, well, fine. All right. We'll give it to the judge. Let him decide.
Yeah, you're damn right we will. And until then, you can stop using your son as a pawn because I'm done giving it to you. I don't care if Kobe Bryant calls. If it's my weekend, TJ's with me. Don't try me, Tom, because next time I'll break your fucking nose.
Hey, thank you.
For what?
Saying I have the best tits of all the moms. But your wife's really aren't that bad. Come on.
Look at you. Always lying around. I spoke to the doctor. Nice boy. And he said, well, I guess you already know what he said. I'm trying hard right now to say something right. But all I can think to say is thank you. Oh, God, that sounds so selfish. But I owe you that. That's what I owe you. You showed me life again. When Marvin died, I wanted to follow him right on up to heaven. I didn't see the beauty of this world. Not in my kids, my grandkids, nowhere. You showed me the colors again. Oh, baby. I'm gonna miss you so damn much. And I don't know why Jesus felt he needed to take you from it too, but he did. And I ain't gonna question his wisdom. Oh, Augie. Oh. I love you, baby. You know that, right? I told you that. I know I did. Not enough, but I know you knew it. Thank you. Thank you, baby. Thank you for loving me. Thank you for that first dance. I'm gonna get me something to eat in the cafeteria. Stomach's rumbling.